I know what you want. I know what you want for me, Lord. But I am human as well. And I refuse to do it. I refuse to keep this portal open. I know what you want me to do. You want me to keep the portal open between myself and my exes. I don't know why I'm saying this on YouTube, because all it's going to do is increase his ego. So I don't know why I'm saying it on YouTube. But I'm taking the pictures down off the wall. I just saw... I don't know why I'm saying this on YouTube, because I'm just increasing his ego. But it's better to be strong on the inside rather than pander to someone's ego on the outside, because that's all it was at the end of the day. Love is freedom itself. How can it have been love? If I look at my life, I can only see very rare examples of love. Extremely rare, exceptionally rare, extraordinarily rare. So, maybe my standards are too high, but my standards are that I love a person with all my mind, body and soul, and that includes helping them regardless of what they've done to me. But I'll admit at times it's just too much. That's why I'm doing this video to God, to say that at times I can't do it. At times I can't do it. That's all I'm going to say. So, I'm sorry for your pictures. You might as well see them, because you might as well see the pictures, because they're going to be taken down now. So it's the last time I'm going to see them in probably a couple of years. So they're going to get taken down. So some more. Some pictures there. I already changed that one. That's what I want to put in them, yeah. I've only kept them up because God keeps saying to me. I know I've left it months and months, but what it is I keep hearing God's voice saying to me, these souls, and this includes Aaron as well, these souls longed to be with you at one time, and that desire carries on. You can't. Thing is, when you meet someone else, obviously you forget about a person, don't you? So I can understand why they do it, because that's the thing to do, isn't it, for unstable people. But what I'm trying to say is that once you have a desire in your mind, the only way to release that desire is to do meditation and prayer and things like that. So getting with someone else might be a temporary solution to a long-term problem, which only exists in your head. It exists deeper in the mind. It exists in the ego, the fabric of the ego. So, for instance, let me say, in my lifetime, I've been with many, many relationships. Would I say many, many men? No. Many, many relationships. And the way I've overcome them is through prayer. prayer releases that sense of ego, that sense of... See, that the problem with many relationships is that it's two egos feeding off each other. And the thing is, it's like having a load of kittens or a load of puppies. When they're all after the mother's milk, one of them, or a couple of them, end up with no milk. Or in other words, what happened with the kittens? One or two of them died, or was it three or four? I can't remember now. This is what I'm saying, that a lot of relationships are the feeding of the ego between each other. Now, I'm not dissing relationships. Relationships are fine. But what I'm saying is that in order for relationships to last many, many years, like, for instance, the Queen, she was married to her husband for, like, 70 years or something like that, or even longer. I don't know exactly, but she was married for at least 70 years. And if you watch programmes about the Queen, you'll notice that every night she kneels down next to her bed and prays for all her family. And she probably did that for her husband as well. And this is the natural way to diffuse the ego or to diffuse that desire. Because what can happen, what has happened between me and a few relationships, the main two being Daniel and Aaron, the main ones is that the feeding of the ego and I'm trying to work it in my head, what God's trying to say to me, the feeding of the ego. But as I said, if they all compete for the mother's milk, then one or two of them, I think it's called the runt of the litter, one or two of them ends up with nothing. So the same thing can happen in relationships. If it's not balanced with things like meditation, prayer, then it won't work. The spiritual side of it. Like, for instance, God saying to me that I should be on my own for a bit. Well, I'm sort of not on my own, but I'm not going to go into who I'm. I'm dating someone, but because we're both very busy people, we don't see each other all the time. But I'm not. I'm playing it. Right. Pardon me. Right, the thing with relationships is if the person moves in straight away, it can be very intense. So God's saying to me that we should have our own independence. And again, this goes back to the metaphor of all the puppies trying to get the milk from the mother dog. That if they all fight over that milk, which is what can happen when partners are together 24 hours a day, it can go a bit wrong. Or 24/7, yeah. The clinginess can become too much, and then it can destroy the relationship unless both people have independence. Like, but independence means more than having friends, doesn't it? It also means having a life. It also means having hobbies, interests. Also means having the money to do whatever you want to do whenever you want to do it. So some people, what holds them together is having no money, where they're both struggling. But
is that really a life?
And doesn't that impact the karmic bonds of those relationships as well, and make them into solid chains where they feel chained together with no freedom?
So,
you know what to do, people. You know the way.
This is what Jesus says.
He says, you know the way. You know what to do. Close your eyes. Focus on your breathing. Visualize what you want. If you want more money, then visualize the word wealth. If you want health, visualize the word health. safety, if you want protection, visualize the word protection. You know the way. Nothing happens in the universe by chance. Everything happens in perfect synchronicity, including your own life. It all happens in perfect synchronicity. There is no such thing as chance. There is no such thing as something happening without a cause. Everything in the universe has a cause. Everything everywhere has a cause. You only have to look, search for the cause in order to find the solution to the problem. Now go away, Liam. So, what is the cause? And to find the cause, we need to search deep within our own heart. What is the cause? So I've been doing meditation now for about 11 years or something like that. I think it goes back to my childhood. I never really felt loved as a child, never, no. And I think this is why I cling to relationships and feel very clingy in relationships. And, you know, it's not fair to say it's the problem of Daniel. It's not fair to say it's the problem of Aaron. The problem, to have a problem with it, with two people in a relationship, both people has to accept some kind of responsibility. So, for instance, I felt very lonely and isolated when I was here and Daniel was in Droitwich. And again, that goes back to my childhood of being feeling very cut off from everyone. It brought back memories of that and other bad memories. So it's not fair to blame anyone, but at the same time, wisdom in our own heart in order to understand what went wrong and what can go right in the future of a relationship. So we say, hang on a minute, what we need is a relationship that has complete freedom, or at least partial freedom. And I think I'm going to achieve this with Chris, because we both have busy lives. The leader of Amitabha Buddhist Meditation Centre in Malvern, she's
friends with him on
Facebook, which is a big thumbs up for me, and makes me realise that as a spiritual leader, as a spiritual teacher,
that he's
a good person for me, a perfect person maybe. The fact that she's friends with him, she's only friends with people who are very spiritual. She's only friends with people who are very, very spiritual souls.
And they are spiritual souls, my
exes are. More or less all of them are spiritual souls. But
I'm not trying to blow my own
trumpet here, but to be with me, they have to be very, very spiritual.
Because
this is how it works, you say. Due to my prayers and meditations, people can sometimes feel, I get this impression, people can sometimes feel a bit standoffish, but
I'm also very human as well.
I'm also very human in the sense that I make mistakes. And I'm learning the whole experience of being human once again.
And
yeah, I don't know what I'm waffling on about. I've got no idea. The words just flow. I don't know what I'm going on about. The words just flow. I have no idea. I end the video and I'm like, what did I say? What was I chatting about? What was I going on about? And then, I don't know unless I watch the videos back what I was chatting about, because I have no idea what I was chatting about. During each video just flows, there's no conscious thought going into these videos. So a lot of the time I'm like, What was I chatting about? So I've been to gym earlier. Got to take Lena for her for a scan tomorrow, see if she's definitely pregnant. Because I took her last week, but they said it was they said they weren't sure because she might be. Well, first they said no, and then the breeder lady said they might be high up in her rib cage, so bring her next week. So I'm taking her in again tomorrow, see what's happening with that. Drive. Which bowl's quite an isolated place if you don't drive. So I've done about 44% of the entire theory test now, which is 1,000 questions. I've got 90% of them right. So once I get above 50, I think I'm going to say to my driving instructor to put me through for the theory, because I want to get at least 500 questions with 50%. With 50% success rate, I want to get at least 50%.
Because the driving, because
otherwise I'm going to be so ahead with the driving that I'm going to actually be doing my practical test at the same time as the theory test. Because I'm already doing all the roundabouts around Worcester, all the busy roundabouts around Worcester and the Bay Park and everything. And I'm thinking that how it's going at the moment, every week of 2 hours, well, I've cut it down to an hour and a half. I'm thinking whether I should do it every other week, because, well, he suggested it. He says, why don't you do it every other week? Because
I was talking about the
puppy I'm going to be getting soon, so.
But
but I can't. Basically, going back to relationships, I can't work with egotistical people. And I've had these pictures up on the wall for months and months and months now, but this is it. I've seen the new pictures of him and his boyfriend on Facebook and Instagram, and it's time for me to say to God, no. He's going to have to find someone else, some other spiritual person. If he wants to find spirituality, he's going to have to do it himself. I refuse to work with him. More pictures. Still owes me £123 anyway, so. Alright, that'll do. Peace, love and blessings.